All right, hello. I am Erin of the Chain Nerd, and I am going to be demonstrating how we read our patterns for European foreign one. So what I've got here is I have my pattern. We do basic pixel art on Microsoft Paint. That is up here at this top left corner, just a little high. And the way we do things, each ring corresponds to one pixel. So one pixel per ring. So when it's finished, each row, this row down here at the bottom, will refer to one row of rings leaning one direction. The next row is what you would consider your connecting row that leans the next direction. And then this one is the rings that lead in the next direction. So three rows of a pattern is one strip, just a plain regular strip of European foreign one. So we have two different methods that we use. We use the backfill method and we use the ignore the first pixel of every other row method, and I'm going to demonstrate both, but I'm going to start with the ignore every other row. So what I do when I'm going to use that method is I just go ahead and mark on my pattern. I am completely ignoring those rings. Those don't exist for me anymore. Those are gone. So what I'll do is I'll make my first fivelet, my first unit of four in one, and it will represent those five rings. You've got your two on top, two on bottom, and then your connecting ring that connects the four, hence four in one. So I'm going to count out, and this is my very, very slow and deliberate method. I don't speed weave this way. If I pick up my first ring, this is going to be the one that joins all four. And just go ahead and pick up these four if I don't drop them. And close our ring, tight closure. Close these, and if you prefer to pre-open, pre-close, however you weave, that's fine, doesn't matter. This is just for illustration purposes. Wiggle them to make sure they're... Alrighty. So I have made my first unit, a foreign one. And you can see the center row, that center ring up here, it leans a different direction than the others. So the top row is leaning over here, middle is trying to go this way, the bottom one leans the same way as the top row. So that's one strip. So when we say alternating directions, that's what we mean by that. So to add on, the way that I add on, the way that I prefer to weave is I weave from the bottom right and I weave across mixed strip. And then I just go across left to right, one ring at a time. You don't have to do it that way. If you prefer to start at the top left and work your way down, start at the right and work your way across, the left work your way across, top down, whatever you prefer to do, it doesn't matter. This is just to show how each ring corresponds to one pixel in the pattern. So I'm going to add on the way that I do, which means I'll be taking a connecting ring, a blue connecting ring, and adding a green at the bottom and a blue at the top. And the way that I do that, find my blue connecting ring. And again, this is illustration purposes. I don't always do things exactly this way. But go ahead and get my blue ring connecting where it needs to go for four in one. And I know I need a green ring to be on the bottom and a blue one to be on the top. So I'm just going to put that blue one, or the green one, on the bottom. Around and find my blue. A single one. Okay. And drop it. The blue on the top. I'm going to close that up. Close those raw rings I just added. That up for you to see. Get on my pattern. Alrighty. So you can see there's three rows of rings making one strip of four in one. Okay, and those represent those three rings. Now for the next, I do the exact same thing again. I just grab my blue and drop it because cooperate. Green and on there. Blue. Don't want to, apparently. Added on here. Now, if I wanted to go upwards and add upwards, super easy. It's the same way you always build with 4-in-1. I'm ignoring this right here. There's no ring there. My first ring I'm going to pick up is going to be that green one. And this is a connecting room. I just weave that in. Laying right, or I can drop it. Okay. See how it corresponds to this one below. You've got your 2, 1, 2, 1, and I'll just continue that across my two blue rings here. So I'm just making a little square. It's just like building regular 4-in-1. All the pattern is doing is telling me which color ring to pick up. Floppy 4-in-1. All right. Now see how it looks narrower than the row above it? Because it is. There's one fewer ring in each of these connecting rows. Did those two rings. So now, I'm going to do the two green and the two blue on the top there. Helps if I grab the right color. Blue is my favorite color, so very easy for me to just want to grab the blue rings. And of course, connected. Green. Blue ring I'd already. Right. So what I just did, two green, two blue. At the top, represented in the pattern. So every single ring represents a pixel. I'm going to finish going all the way up to the top. So again, I'm ignoring this, so it's just one green. Two blue. Drop them. now I have added one rings. And now I'd repeat this, two green, two blue. So then I just repeat again, and it still show you your final height. Oh. Green. No, they look gray on camera. Not seafoam. And I just do four green across the top. Finish that top. And if you can hear any noises in the background, I apologize. I have three children, and they are home at the moment. All right, so there we go. That is that whole left side, and all what I did was just ignoring this one. So that's the just ignore every other. Now, if I wanted to do the backfill and include every single ring in the pattern to make it easier to calculate ring counts, where you're not counting that you're ignoring one ring every other row, all you do, since I was just ignoring one on this side, I'd find my connecting rows, so that's your even-numbered rows, and I would just add a ring in those gaps there. So if I want to say that I did every single ring in the pattern, that's what I'd do. You just find your connecting rows, not to drop your rings like I do, and just add those. That edge, add four of them. Like to flop around until it's a little bit bigger, more to hang on to. Alright. So now those are all filled in. Now what this does, let me hold it up. There's a reason I don't do this one as much anymore. You can, but I usually tend to like to add an extra row at the top and the bottom when I do this, because it makes your final rows look like they're one row short. They look indented a little bit. Which, if you don't mind that, totally cool. That's absolutely a matter of taste. But let me throw things. but yeah, so what that did was just add little rings that are sticking out right there. So you can do it without, and you're just ignoring every other connecting row, that first ring. Or you can go back once you're done and add those in, or do it as you're weaving, does not matter. But yeah, and so this is, also we tend to weave vertically like this with the rings, the pattern going upwards. You absolutely can weave with your rings what they call the wrong way, where the pattern goes horizontally. It looks more like a knitted scarf that way. I don't know if anybody knits, but more like a knitted pattern. But yeah, you can weave that way. Our patterns are usually geared more towards weaving vertically because the lines will look different depending on which way you weave it. Vertically, you can see a single line of rings much more clearly. It stands out. You can see this very, very clear edge. But when you're weaving the other way, when you're weaving so the rings lay horizontally like this, the lines will look different. So if you're using one of our patterns, know that we usually make our patterns with this in mind, with the rings vertically the right quote-unquote way. Artistically speaking, there's no right or wrong way. It's all a matter of taste, your personal project. But if you intend to weave with your rings the other way, please do let us know. So we'll make sure that we have the lines oriented correctly and thicken the pattern in the right places so that your image will show up correctly. So that is the basic one ring per pixel, how we weave it with the ignore method or with the backfill method. If you have any further questions, please always feel free to reach out to us and let us know if there's anything that's not clear. But that is the way that we follow patterns. From there, you can just add wherever and however you want. Just know every even row is a connecting row, but each pixel is one ring and three rows of a pattern is one regular strip of 4-in-1. And if you're going vertically, it's the one and then two, one and then two across here. If you're ignoring, every other row, there's your one. These are the two that it corresponds to. Two, one, two, one, two, one. Okay? So thank you for watching. I hope that this has been helpful. Excuse me, I got tongue-tied. I hope that this has been helpful. And happy weaving!